chime in and call to worship. Blessed are those who consider the poor. The Lord delivers them in a day of trouble.
Thank you. Great Almighty God, we thank you again for the ability to come and to kneel before you, not only with our knees, but with our hearts and our souls today. For God, you are the Lord who hears our cry. You are the Lord that heals our infirmities, that brings us back from brokenness, and makes us whole once again. Lord, we know that it's not because of what we do, or even trying to earn your love. It's because your grace is offered freely. And Lord, it was with even joy that you endured the cross, so that, God, we could become yours once again. So, God, as we, your church, gather, we first just lift up your name and praise you. And remember this great story. It's been told and passed down to us. And that, Lord, we know it is true because of our own hearts now and fellowship with you. And so, Lord, we rejoice as your people here today. And God, one of those great mysteries that even in our rejoicing, Lord, many of us are here and Lord at the same time. But God, you walked among us. You know what it was to be on this earth, to experience trials of many types, to lose loved ones, to be oppressed, to be hungry and cold, and Lord, to wonder what the next moment would hold. And so God, as we're here today, we come to you for comfort, for we know that you understand our hurt, you understand what we go through, and that, Lord, you have sympathy upon us. And God, with that sympathy, you also bring power of your Holy Spirit. And so we claim that here today, Lord, that those that were feeling sick, they would be healed. Those that have been going through surgeries or waiting for a special appointment with you, may, Lord, they be healed now. God, for us that are here today that do feel just a sense of burden upon this world, whether it's through just anxiousness, whether it's through just not knowing the future, whether, Lord, our jobs are in jeopardy, or whether, Lord, we just wonder about our loved ones that are making bad decisions. God, we pray for your peace upon us. Lord, we also ask that in this moment that you would be upon those that have lost loved ones, that those that mourn here today would even have their hearts filled with gladness to know that we are in your hands and no one can take us from you. Lord, we also just lift up those here today that are struggling with all sorts of burdens, whether they're addictions, broken relationships, or just the burdens of life. May God, you bless us and make us wise to walk in your way. Lord, for those that come here this morning seeking your special touch, may you bless them. Lord, our prayer requests are always brought before you. We pray for those as well. And God, for us that are going to annual conference, for Larry, for Mike, and for myself, we now pray.
Father Jesus, in a special way, I want to say thank you. Especially we want to commit ourselves into your hands. Pastor Jonathan, Lau, our deputy, Ma, as the lead to represent our African conference. God, we pray that you would direct the time. We pray whatever you do, you will strengthen them. You will help them to be a blessing. Do not only the Western Red Conference, but the entire United Methodist Church. Lord, I want to say thank you. We pray for the Holy Spirit upon you. As they leave, you can send your love on them. I want to say thank you, Jesus. I want to lift this prayer to you. And it is in your name. I want to offer the prayer to us many years ago. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on the earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses. Amen.
chose to call this their church. May it strengthen and continue this church and grow this church. May it help us continue our faith and our walk in your world, we pray. Amen.
Preached
in his name to all the nations. Beginning at Jerusalem, you are the witness of these things. I'm going to send you what my Father has promised. But stay in the city until you have been clothed and powered from on high. When he had led them out to the vicinity of Bethany, he lifted up his hands and blessed them. While he was blessing them, he left them and was taken up into heaven. Then they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy. And they stayed continually at the temple, praising God. Here ends the written word.
Amen. Thank you, Ryan.
Thank you, Phil.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
For those of you who are watching online, I want to say welcome. For those of you who will watch it later, I want to say welcome. Terry, truly, Christ is risen. Today, my message will really focus on Christ is alive. For some of you who know me, just I think 4 years ago, or almost five years in this church, I briefly want to introduce myself to you briefly. My name is Andrew B. Nimely. I am the lead speaker within the United Methodist West Ohio Conference. Some of you will say, why is that? Why is that? It is just someone who is called upon any time to preach the good news of the Lord Jesus Christ as the request of our pastor. So for this, I want to say thank you, Pastor Jenna, for the opportunity to serve. With almost 20 years in the United States, I entered as a political refugee at age 30. With only high school education. Through God's plan, I have earned an associate and a bachelor of science degree in accounting and forensic accounting and a master of business administration. I'm very blessed. I'm very blessed man to marry a beautiful wife, a beautiful woman. And we are blessed with 7 kids.
Amen.
I want to say thank you, kids, for coming. Even though I'm in pain now because one of my daughters is not here, but I pray that I continue to bless her. In addition, we operate 2 small businesses. And I teach Microsoft application at Columbus State Community College for 4 years now. Folks, I am not praying. It is God's faithfulness and grace. Will you pray with me, please? Lord Jesus, I am an empty vessel. I pray that the Holy Spirit in this place right now, that you bless the word of my mouth. And a meditation on my heart. I want to say thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. At age 19, as I graduated from high school, 1989, during the onset of the Liberian Civil War, I lost my father to stroke. I vividly remember the pain of losing a mentor and a dad, someone I look up to. But you being told, I was not ashamed. I knew it was better for him because the war was approaching where he was living. He died on May 5th, 1990, at the age of 55. For example, just within this congregation, I have witnessed and observed the painful death of death to love you. I pray for you every day.
Furthermore,
I have listened to numerous stories of family losing a loved one in service community. At the time of my father's death, I did not have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. But now, church, presently, I have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you. God is grateful. Jesus Christ has given me hope that my dear father, my kid's grandfather, my beautiful wife, father-in-law, is alive. You need to believe that. It was God's plan. So church, Christ has already redeemed my father's sin through his blood. Folks, Peterson, in the message, put it this way. Stay, it is what God has in mind long ago before Christ's birth. To cross Jesus with pain. The plan was that he gave himself as an offering for all of us. So that, as a result, we can see more life. More life. And more life. And God's plan will deeply prosper him. Was deeply prosper through him. That Isaiah 5:10. And we all see that. God's plan prosper through us. It is his grace. It is not our work. It is not who we are. It is not where we come from. But it is his grace. So my friends, even though death has crushed the physical body of my father, who does not have a grave or burial site as I speak to you right now in my baby. But one thing I want you to know, friend, God wants you and me and both, especially those of you who lost loved ones, to remember this. There is an abundance of life in heaven. And all of humanity who have gone to the grave beyond is still alive. I need you to believe that. Just believe that God is faithful. Scripture tells us that when Jesus was taken up into heaven, he will come back in the same way according to Acts 1:11.
Amen.
So imagine. We all will meet our loved ones in heaven, and we will celebrate with them once again on that fateful day when we all, the favorite song writer said, when we all come together.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Yes, that's true. We will see them. Glory. When we all get to heaven, we will sing songs of joy. And praise God. Friends, today is a new day in the life of our family. Filming for now, we all will witness God's grace and blessing being poured on our son Bishop. We truly are grateful. I truly see my father in our son. I've told him this before. This is the first time he did hear this from me. You will say, why, Andrew? Yes, he is my father. Before Bishop was born, I received a clear message in the spirit from my late father. He said, son, you will have a child, and that child is Bishop. So think just for a moment how terrifying that conversation was. With ultrasound at that time in life. I want to repeat that. With ultrasound at that time in life. I believe the message because it was real. It was not a dream. I want to believe that.
Praise the Lord.
I saw his face clearly. Church, it was my father who could not talk to me, or who never had an opportunity to speak to me during the last moment of his death. When I came abroad, you know, in Africa, they will always give you a high school clearance. I was married to another lady, my stepmother. And I took my clearance to him and to show it to him to celebrate. To say, Dad, I graduated. But believe it, he couldn't speak to me. He was on his dad room there. I could see that tears of joy. He couldn't speak to me. So it's painful. So friends, imagine to see what occurred 20 years ago at conception, meaning our bishop. It was truly remarkable because my father did not have the opportunity to see me graduate, but he gave me and my family a chance to see him in a new direction. God is faithful. He is the same person 84 years ago because I see his character displayed right in front of my eyes, even though, honestly, I sometimes put pressure on Bishop. He answered why. He don't know, but this is the story. He never had the opportunity. I never had the opportunity to hear. I said, you know, you're my father. I want for you to be the greatest. And Bishop wanted to hear that. That's why I made him go over. That's why he do a lot. And so he questioned us and have a family maybe why now you will get to know, but that's the story. You are my father, boy. For example, church, believing the dream of your father or loved one is amazing, but more important, believing the dream that Jesus Christ is alive is more remarkable. It is. Remember, God has a plan for you and me. Scripture says, do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayers and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. That is Philippians 4:6. Therefore, folks, in our laws, let us be hopeful, knowing that Jesus Christ is alive within us. Let us believe and have faith through all our suffering. Believe it. As I say, I wasted a lot of the pain someone go through every day. I will speak of my father. So all our difficulty, let us believe in God. In the scripture reading, I just read, Jesus reminded us of the plan that God has for us when he sent a greater comforter. He said, stay there. I will send someone. It is in each of us. All we need to do to pray so that can be activated, so he can control us. The Holy Spirit guides, even though sometimes I personally, this is a true story, experience the pain of losing my father. But my father and I are grateful to God for the blessing bestowed on us, especially bringing us to the new promised land. If you don't believe it, America is a new promised land. By directing our journey every day, I have not went back 20 years ago, I never stepped back home. This is our country, and it is God's grace. It is a direction. Never knew I could ever come to the United States. Never dreamed of it. So God is faithful. He has a plan.
Amen.
My friend, with no biological parents present in my life, God has blessed me with two incredible I hope you are watching that. Or sometime later on you may watch. And Larry Hart. Larry ran this church. Folks, just for a second. Think of losing your father at an early age, then God who promised us. He always promised. He can't fail. He show up. Big time. And bless me with two incredible men in my life. Thank you, Larry, for being my father and shepherd. And to all my shepherds and all men who are interacting with him, I want to say thank you. Because you have grown me in a way that I see everyone in God. And thank you, Grant, for the fatherly love over the years. As we celebrate the ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, this is an important day. He is risen. And Terry, again, I want to say thank you for that special spirit. Christ is risen, for no, he is in our life. I want to remind us that the Messiah, our God, our Lord, our Father, Jesus Christ, is risen for the repenting of our sin, forgiving us of our sin. He is seated at the right hand of God the Father. He will come in glory to restore a new order for us as believers. You may say a new day, but it will be a new order that we all will share that together.
Amen.
Why? Because he shared his precious blood freely for you and for me. I pray that we will always, in all our situations, in all our circumstances, to lean on Jesus Christ in everything we do through active listening, prayer, praises, thanksgiving. For Christ is a caring shepherd who knows each one of us by our need, through our happiness, through our mystery, journey of life. Let us fear no evil. Let us listen and know Christ is risen and he is alive. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, brother. As we continue to worship, we come to the Lord's table. Let us prepare our hearts and minds. Lord Jesus Christ, we, your people, remember here today that we are yours. And that you have called us by name to come here today to remember your great story and to remember, Lord, your love for us. And so, God, it's with great joy that we take just a moment to remind ourselves of the life that you came and lived on this earth. Lord, you bled. Lord, you hurt. You went tired nights. You endured storms. You did it all for us. And Lord, on the night in which you were betrayed, you took bread. You broke the bread and gave it to your disciples. You said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And Lord, when the supper was over, you took the cup, gave thanks to the Lord, gave it to your disciples, and said, "Take, drink. This is the blood of my new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you drink it, do this in remembrance of me." And so, Lord, in these your mighty acts, we give you joy and thanksgiving and ask you to make these gifts be the body and blood of Christ. That as we take them, Lord, we would be reunited with you, and that you would make us be the body of Christ for this world. Lord, as we come to this table, we take just a moment to remember it's not of our own accord, but of your grace. And so, Lord, we take a moment to repent of our sins as we quietly name them before you. Church, hear the good news. Christ died for sinners. You are forgiven. Lord, we thank you so much for the power of your spirits. And as we partake here today, we give you all glory and honor and praise your name. Amen. Just a moment, I'll give you a couple of directions. We will be taking by passing of the plate. Just a moment, the ushers will come forward and we'll be passing around the bread. You just take a piece of the bread and hold on to it. Once everybody's been served, we will then take it together. And then we'll do the same with the cup as it comes around. We do have some gluten-free elements. So I will walk around in just a moment with those. If you need those, just kind of raise your hand as I walk around. I'll be sure to make you go my way over to you. Make sure you have that. With those helping with communion, now come forward.
Thank you. blood of Christ poured out for us, we give thanks to him. Lord, you have proven your love toward us once again.
So if you have graduated from high school, or if you got maybe a degree, either you know bachelor's, master's, whatever, feel free to come on down. We want to recognize you at this time.
I'll be graduating this Saturday from Groveport Madison High School, and my plans are to attend Columbus Community State College for pursuing my career in HVAC.
Good Bishop, we're going to pray for you in just a minute, but I want to present to you a Bible. Now, I want you to know this is a special Bible. I picked it out myself. It has colored pictures in it. And it really does, but they are grown-up colored pictures. Okay, it's to you. It is actually a really good Bible. It had, out of all the ones I looked at, it had the best ability to share with you the cultural backgrounds going on at the time of reading it, which a lot of times when you come across scripture, you go, what's going on here? This helps you to answer that. So I hope that you read it every single day and that you cherish it every time you do, you think of us.
I will.
Yeah. We're going to pray over Bishop. So I'm going to ask him, if you would, first of all, just face this way. And if you have been part of Bishop's life in any significant way, when you come, we're going to lay hands on him at this time. Bishop, we give thanks to God. You have been a blessing to this church, and the many people, Lord, that come here to lay hands on you, to send you a blessing on your way. May God, may you make this firm in his heart, in his mind. Lord, you would always remember this place, remember where he comes from, and whenever he comes across hard times, or whatever life throws at him, may Lord, these hands be firm and hold him up. God, we love you. We praise you for the blessing that he is. We pray for a great future for him. We pray that you'd open up doors and paths for him to not only have a fulfilling career, to have a beautiful family if he so desires, but also, God, to grow closer to you every single day of his life. And that, God, he would spread your gospel, whatever ways that you prepared him, whatever lies that he comes across, that all people would say, I have been blessed by your bishop. We pray this in your name. Amen.
Amen.
Don't go anywhere yet. Bishop, I want you to turn around. I want you to face this family one more time. I have some words of encouragement to let you know. So, in the days ahead, you may wake up one day and you may find yourself thinking, wow, I'm really messed up. Wow, I'm really not on the right path that I thought I'd be on. Maybe I just didn't see the future panning out this way. I want you to look around. This is your home. These are your people. You can always come home. We love you.
morning for our closing hymn, He Lives.
Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.